If you have a 401k at work, you might also know that you might be able to take a 401k loan, but should you? Hi, I'm Joseph.
And I'm Tasha with One Big Happy Life, and we help you find balance, build wealth, and live happy. Everything that you need to create the life that you want.
So we have talked a lot about the benefits of using retirement plans at work and investing, but there's another part of your employer's retirement plan, and that is a 401k loan, where you can actually take money out of your retirement plan and then use it for some purpose while paying it back to the retirement plan.
And now the general consensus is that 401k loans are really, really bad. But if you've watched any of our net worth update videos, you know that we have one. So we get a question fairly often, like, why do we have a 401k loan and are 401k loans a good idea? So that's what we're going to be talking about today.
Okay, so they're not all bad. There are some cases where a 401k loan could be something that you would want to do. Now, so let's look at kind of the benefits and the whys of that. Now, the first thing is, well, because it's your money that you're taking out, you don't go to a bank, you don't have to submit an application, you don't have to have your credit checked, you can just pay whatever fee is associated with it, if any, and then just take your money out. So it's a pretty simple process.
And so why or in what instances would you want to or consider taking out a 401k loan? So one instance would be if you want to diversify your investments in a different way from what is offered, say, within your 401k, or even if you were to roll it over to a self-directed retirement account, any investment options there. So it just allows you more flexibility with your money.
Yeah, and if you have paid in a whole bunch, you're way ahead on your savings, well, you're not going to care that much about moving something out of your 401k into something else, and you're planning on paying it back anyway. So that seems like something that, you know, is a viable option.
Yeah, in other words, it can be a really convenient way to choose to self-finance things. And really, you should only consider it if you are good with your finances, if you know you're going to pay the money back, and if your job is extremely secure. Because if you lose your job, the amount will automatically become due, and then you'll have to pay it or else run the risk of incurring penalties.
Yeah, which is a perfect segue into some of the risks with it. And the biggest one is, of course, that you're going to have to pay the penalty and income taxes if you don't pay back the loan. And so if you lose your job, or you just don't have the means to then pay it back because you spent it on, you know, whatever, and then you don't have the cash flow to do it, well, then that's going to trigger those income taxes and usually 10% penalty, which that's not fun paying that back. Plus, you've lost that money forever and from your retirement plan, because you can't go back and make up the difference later if you've been caught by that penalty.
The other major risk is that because that money is no longer invested in the stock market, well, you lose any gains that money would have earned while it's still in the stock market. So that's a pretty big risk, that you'll end up losing money by doing that.
Now, there are pros to taking that 401k loan. The first being that the interest that's being charged on that 401k loan actually goes back into your account. So essentially, you're just paying yourself some interest, which that's not that bad. That seems okay.
And the interest rate tends to be really low. I think ours is like, what, 1% or something like that. But again, you've got to offset that by the fact that it's not getting those gains in the market that it would have already been getting, otherwise been getting.
Yeah, and that interest rate is definitely going to be dependent on your particular 401k plan. It's not going to be universal. But another pro is the fact that you can invest that money that you take out. So let's say you're taking out that 401k loan and you're going to go and buy some assets that you couldn't get within that 401k. And then you're going to go ahead and then pay that money back. Well, you could acquire something like a business that's going to produce money for you, or some real estate, some rental properties. without having to go through the hassle of rolling over a piece of the 401k, even if you're allowed to at the time, into like a self-directed IRA and then make those investments. It's a whole lot more streamlined to just take that 401k loan and then buy that investment outside.
So then the major pro, and probably the most obvious pro, is that it saves you time. Because I'm sure that a lot of people are like, well, in any one of these instances, you can save all of those cons, not have to worry about all of that, by not touching your 401k and instead using cash and waiting and saving up enough money. So what the 401k loan does, what any amount of debt does, is save you time by allowing you to pay money for the convenience of saving time. And the thing to keep in mind with savings is when you stop and save that money, the money is still sitting outside of the market anyway, right? So if you had that money in your 401k and you decided not to touch it, and instead you're going to leave that money in your 401k, but any new contributions won't go to your 401k and instead will go to this savings pot, well, that money would have been sitting outside the market anyway. And then the other thing is, if your 401k has matching and you're vested, you can borrow against money that you didn't personally put into the 401k, because your employer contributions become your money. So basically, you can hit those savings goals faster by leveraging the matching portion of your 401k in your 401k loan.
All right, now let's flip over to the cons. What's not so great about a 401k loan? Well, we mentioned a few minutes ago the risks associated with it, that you're going to be hit with penalties and paying the taxes on it if you're unable to pay it back. So those risks are significant depending on your particular financial situation, but maybe not that big a deal for everyone. It just kind of depends.
So clearly there are pros and cons, pluses and minuses to taking out a 401k loan, and they really depend on what you intend to do with the money and what the state of your savings is as well. But let's talk about areas where you'll definitely want to avoid a 401k loan. So number one, if you're just going to be using it to pay off other debts, especially unsecured debts. We've talked about this before, but the money in your 401k loan is basically immune from creditors. And so if anything were to go down with your finances, you lose your house, you get sued, that nest egg is safe and protected. If you take out a 401k loan to pay off other loans that have no recourse otherwise, like a credit card bill, or frankly, even to keep a roof over your head when you could go rent instead and just keep your nest egg, well, that's generally a bad idea. You want to keep that money safe as much as possible.
Yeah, and another time that you do not want to be borrowing money from your retirement is if you are not hitting your minimum savings rate anyway. And so that's the amount that you need to be saving every single month to have the retirement that you want to have. And so if you're not hitting that, taking that money out and then having to pay it back, you're going to end up crunching yourself for cash and you're going to be even further behind. For two reasons. You're not going to have the cash flow to put that much more money back, potentially, because you're already missing your minimum savings rate. But also, you're taking that money out of what's hopefully broadly invested in the market, and you're going to lose that return. So that's dangerous.
Yeah, and along those lines, you also want to avoid it if you are not ahead of your retirement savings, for all of the same reasons. Because if you're not already ahead, then you're just putting yourself even further behind. And so it's gonna be that much harder to catch up. So to talk about our 401k loan, so we took out our 401k loan five years ago. Mm-hmm. And it was a conscious decision. And we definitely weighed our options between, and we used our 401k loan to buy our house. So while we don't generally consider a primary residence to be an investment, that money is certainly sitting in real estate, right? And so we weighed the pros and cons about like stopping and saving up for the down payment. We looked at the impact that pulling that money out would have on our long-term wealth building goals. And we were already ahead in saving for retirement. So we felt very comfortable with that, in that it wouldn't make that much of a difference to us financially if we pulled the money out and paid it back slowly, or if we stopped and saved for, like, you know, 6 months to a year before we bought a house. But it did make a huge difference for us time-wise, because it was the beginning. Alexis was going to be starting a new school year, and if we rented, it was going to be in a different school district from where we were going to buy. And for us, moving our timeline up a good 6 months to 9 months actually made a huge difference for our family in terms of what it would have meant for Alexis. Having to change schools to 3 school years in a row was just too much, including starting high school with people that she didn't even know.
Yeah, and it's worked out that we're, of course, ahead in our savings. Still. And we knew that at the time, that it was going to work out this way. And so very comfortable doing that. Now, when is it a good time for you to consider a 401k loan? Well, I would recommend that you usually would look at this when you are ahead on your retirement savings. So like the position where you could just cut your savings, not save anymore, and you're going to have enough in retirement. That's an ideal scenario to then say, okay, well, I could take some money out of my 401k and do something else, like get an investment that's not available, a business, some real estate. That is a perfect opportunity to do that self-financing 401k.
And the other instance where we would say you should definitely consider it no matter what, even if you're not ahead on your retirement savings, is if you need that money to save someone's life. And I think we talk about this a lot, you know, this push to be debt-free, but if anyone was in a circumstance where they needed a whole bunch of money in order to save a person's life, so for example, if you need a transplant, I hear that you have a better shot of actually getting a transplant if you're committed to flying wherever there is an organ that's available. And so what that means is chartering a private flight to fly you across the country in short notice. And so, you know, just recognizing what's most important here and where your priorities should be in life, we have to say that if it's a medical emergency and you need that money to save someone's life or else, well, you're going to do that, right? Who's going to say no to a loved one, to say, no, you can't have a heart because my 401k? Like,
yeah, I mean, that's a pretty tough sell for your family, right? And the reason that we say, well, why wouldn't you just cash that out? And you might have to if you go over the limit of whatever 401k loan is available to you. But it's better if you can just take it as a 401k loan, because at least you can conceivably pay it back over time.
Exactly. All right, guys. So there you have it. Should you take out a 401k loan? The answer is it depends. But we've given you a lot to think about so that you can make a well-informed decision for yourself should you ever be in that position.
And we'll see you guys next time.
Bye.